Healthcare in Mexico is very good. It's actually rated higher than the United States. And I was nervous like everybody when I first moved here. Like, oh my God, what if something happens? What am I going to do? The fact is that when I've had some medical issues here, and they've been minor, knock on wood, I've been able to go to a local doctor. In fact, almost all the pharmacies have a doctor attached to the pharmacy. So if you need a prescription written, you just go to that doctor, and it costs about $3 to go to that doctor. But if you had a broken leg, you wouldn't go to that doctor. You would go to a hospital, and I do have health insurance in the United States. I have Medicare in the United States, and I've used it in the past for things like the chiropractor or wants to go to an ear doctor, and it was fine. It was a lot of paperwork and very little personal service. And here, there's a lot of personal service. The doctors actually talk to you. They want to know about you. They want to, but you bring your own records, which is sort of interesting. And every single visit in Mexico starts with your lab test. So if you're going to a doctor, unless it's an emergency, you would get your lab tests first. But if it's an emergency, you go, it doesn't matter. They'll give you the lab tests, there. And from the lab test, they decide, and of course, physical exam. They decide, what you need, what's going on with your body, which is kind of cool. And again, a lab test, when I had them done before my facelift last year, I think it cost me, oh, I don't know, something like $75 for 5 pages worth of tests for everything. They tested me for everything. Hepatitis, I mean, everything they tested me for. And so that was really great because the doctor then know, the surgeons then know what to deal with, how fast or how slow you. But anyway, they also have free health insurance here that would not cover something like cosmetic surgery. But since I live here, the fact of the matter is, if there's an emergency and there was a problem, I'm going to be seen first by Mexican doctors. So I decided I would sign up for Seguro Popular, which is a basic kind of health insurance. If you want more, then there are very modest amounts of insurance that you can buy. So in order to sign up, you have to have a visa, a permanent or temporary visa, and you have to have a recent utility bill. It can't be more than 90 days old. So I thought, great, no problem. I just got my utility bill. It was the date on it was February 15th, and I went in there about March 30th thinking, got this. And because it's less than 90 days. So I hand in my IDs and my copies of my passport and stuff. And the woman looks at my utility bill and she says, This is old. Do you have another one? Do you have a telephone bill? I said, no, I don't have a telephone bill because I don't get one actually. I just go to a kiosk and I pay some money and how much I know. It comes up. You put in your phone number and it tells you how much you owe. I said, but it's February 15th and it's only March 30th now. She said, no. It's December 17th. Well, the bill was billed from December 17th to February 17th because it's a 2-month bill. And they take it from the date of service, not the date the bill was issued. I went, all right, this is a different way of looking at things. So anyway, she issued me a provisional one to show me to come back when I had a new one, which really meant you have about 15 days if you're using your electric bill from the time you get the bill, because the bill is 2 months old. They're dating from the date of service. So about a week or so ago, I got my bill and I dashed in there and I signed up, and now I'm covered in two nations if anything should happen. Knock on wood. So far, so good. That's my news from Mexico today. If you happen to be visiting or if you're thinking about moving here, you should look into something like that. Love you. Bye.